In case you were wondering, yes, I'm in a boat. It's a kayak, actually. No, it's not mine. No, but listen, no.
Whatever, man.
Listen, you want a video or not? Drew, I'm going to have to take frequent pauses to adjust myself. A salary arbitrator has come to a conclusion, a reward, if you will, for the contract of Ilya Samsonov with the Toronto Maple Leafs. Let's talk about it. But first, think you know which way it's going to go? Not like the arbitration. I mean, like other stuff. Baseball, tennis, golf. Sports Interaction has it all. Pre-game, live in play, or one of their many prop bets. Want to bet? Head to sportsinteraction.com/SDPN and download the Sports Interaction app, but only if you're 19 plus. Please play responsibly. It's like a life jacket.
Don't make fun of me. It looks cool.
All right, so here's what's happened today from my kayak. The Leafs and Ilya Samsonov have come to a resolution, if you will, after going to salary arbitration. And like I said in my last video, it started ridiculous because most cases that go to salary arbitration are kind of ridiculous. The Leafs offered Samsonov $2.4 million. That's not nearly enough. Samsonov asked for $4.9 million. That's way too much. So everyone came to the conclusion that the arbitrator is going to do what the arbitrator very often does, and that's split it right down the middle. Now, the arbitrator didn't quite do that. Sort of. Very close. The one-year contract at $3.55 million is almost right down the middle, but not quite. A contract right down the middle. You can hear me adjusting the kayak in the water. A real contract, a real right down the middle contract for what Samsonov was asking for versus what the Leafs were asking for would have been 3.65. So it's not quite down the middle, but it's close. There's some ducks. And it's actually like a decent win for the Leafs in that regard, because they weren't just $10,000 apart, like my friend who can't do math says. They were actually $100,000 apart. So 3.65, 3.55 is $100,000 better against the cap. So that's good. Like, it's good. Samsonov is locked up to one more year. It's going to be Samsonov, probably Joseph Woll. They're going to try to tie Matt Murray to a Rocket. There have been rumors of Brian Elliott being signed. I don't know if the plan is for him to be the backup or to be the third goalie. Eric Shellgren has already left town. Now, here's the other issue. At the end of Samsonov's one-year contract, it's not going to be like it was this year. Samsonov had a one-year deal with the Leafs under very unique circumstances. The Washington Capitals let him walk 1 year, 1.8. He ended up doing better than anybody could have possibly hoped for him to do, and that was great news. At the end of this deal, no matter how good or bad he does, he's going to be an unrestricted free agent, and he can walk, he can sign anywhere for whatever length of time that he wants to. There have been lots of rumors that the Leafs never wanted a long-term deal here. I think three, Elliot Friedman said, was the longest they were willing to go. Let's be honest. Unfortunately, if you're an Ilya Samsonov fan, today's ruling likely means he'll be on the Leafs next year. That's good. But probably not for the long term. The other bad news to go with all that, salary arbitration is famously tumultuous and confrontational. And Jeff O'Neill has talked about it, going to salary arbitration. And, you know, basically the team that you play for and, you know, spill blood and guts for, Samsonov was, he was the starting goaltender when the backup was like a university student to basically help the Leafs afford Matthew Nyes, help the Leafs down their stretch run. And he did all that in an effort to try to win the Stanley Cup. He won them their first series that they have won in 19 years. And then they go to essentially court, but it's an arbitrator. And a GM who just got there is there arguing, hey, you're not actually as good as you're asking for. Now, some of you might look at that and go, oh, boo-hoo, because we've all gone to our boss and asked for more money, and they don't even tell us we're bad. They just go, yeah, no. I get that, but in the world of hockey, like, there's a very, very small amount of these arbitration decisions handed out every year, and it's not very often that they're long for the team that they're with. I mean, look at the statement that the Leafs put out. They didn't even say, hey, we've signed Samsonov. Like, it wasn't this big celebration. It was just, the judge has awarded this arbitration case, blah, 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 blah. It's very Dwight Schrute. It is your birthday. I state my regret. Here's the other little bit of sort of bad news, but I would just call it incomplete news. The Leafs very obviously are over the cap if you have capfriendly.com. Now, the problem with that is you're not supposed to be over the cap. You're not allowed. But you're allowed to go over the cap by, I think it's $8 million roughly in there over the course of the summer. There's lots that can still happen. Sam Lafferty has been brought up many times. Connor Timmins has been brought up many times. I think the biggest one is obviously what's going to happen with Matt Murray. But then in the middle of me saying the biggest one, there could also be, the potential that Jake Muzzin's contract gets traded. Still don't know what's going on with William Nylander. Still don't know what's going on with Austin Matthews. All we really have is Elliot Friedman having a report about a week ago basically saying, yeah, nothing's really close. So look, it's not all bad. All it means is the new GM has some new GM work to do, and that's A-okay. And if you were worried about the Leafs not having a starting goalie next year, don't worry. They got one. It's Ilya Samsonov. Very unlikely Matt Murray ever plays a game for the Toronto Maple Leafs again. Maybe they'll sign another guy, maybe, but I think Joseph Woll is going to be the backup next season. He was good last season in the minors and in the NHL. And if the Leafs want to send him down to the Marlies, he can be the starter there. Not quite, because he'll require waivers, and I would imagine someone will claim him. So in very likelihood, it's going to be Ilya Samsonov backed up by Joseph Woll, and there could be a veteran involved in there as well. So that's all from here in my kayak. So that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends to thank producer Drew for editing this one. I hope you don't get motion sickness. Shout out to associate producer Big Red for making sure I got in my kayak safe and handing me my phone.